Christmas is around the corner and everyone is happy, but you look sad. Or you're thinking what to put up in your room, how to decorate it and make it look spectacular. No sweat, because I'm here and I'm going to teach you how to make some simple balloon orbs. Trust me, they are really fun to make and they can really light up your room. So get ready. And to make these cool balloon orb decorations, you need some material. Here's the list. All right, let's get started and make some baubles. Not bubbles, baubles. Say with me, baubles. Okay, let it be. So the first step is, we'll take a balloon and we blow it. All right. Now we are not going to fully inflate the balloon because we need a nice ball or a bauble size. Also, we want it to be soft because this will help us remove the string from it easier. So now let's tie a knot. All right, our bauble shape is now ready. We'll keep this aside and we'll take a bowl and make some Fevicol MR and water solution. Okay, we are going to pour some Fevicol MR in the bowl. You need lots of it, like you can see. But this also depends on the number of baubles you're making. So don't waste glue. And now we'll add a little bit of water. And now we'll mix it well. Mix it well so you have a nice consistency. There should be no lumps like this. Look at that. It's ready. And now we're going to use string. What we're going to do is, we'll take the solution and we'll dip some in the solution so that it's nicely coated, needs to absorb all the solution. Guys, this can get a little messy, so you need to put a little newspaper or a rag or a cloth nearby because this will create a mess. Now, we'll take the string and place it over the balloon and tie a knot like this. I'm leaving a little bit so I can hold it. And now we'll just go around the balloon like that. Now all you need to do is just go around like this, covering all the small gaps and keep dipping the thread in this solution and keep wrapping the balloon. Basically, you need to make a web or a mesh like this, and once you're happy and you see it's nicely covered, you can stop, use the last bit, cut it, and tie a knot. All right, with that, our bauble is now ready. Using the same process, you can make as many as you want. Now, all you need to do is hang this in a nice, cool, dry place. Also, keep a newspaper below it because it will drip, or you can keep it on a container like this one. And let it dry. This usually takes 24 hours to dry, so I'm gonna keep it aside and finish off my work. So you can also do your daily chores. I'm gonna start by cleaning up this place, washing my hands, and a few other things. So see you in a bit. It's time. Let's check. Okay. And this is still wet. But lucky for you guys, I kept one ready right here. Ta-da! So you have to wait for it to dry nicely like this. And when it's dried properly, it becomes hard. Watch this. Can you hear that? Now all you need to do is take a pencil and with the back end of the pencil, you have to just push the balloon away like that. This makes the process of removing the balloon easier. Looks like we are done. Now all we need to do is burst the balloon. Our bauble is ready. Pretty impressive, huh? But I'll show you how you can make this look even cooler. We'll take some more of this solution and dab some of the solution on top of the thread. Now make sure you don't put too much because that will again make the thread wet and then it will destroy the shape of the bauble. Have a nice and even coat and make sure it doesn't collect in any of these corners. So only the thread should get wet with the solution. And then part by part, you can keep adding glitter. And now you can keep doing the process till the whole bauble is nice and sparkly. And there you have it, shiny disco ball. Look at that. And this way you can make shiny baubles with this fun and easy technique. And if you want it to shine even brighter, you can put some fairy lights inside and watch the funky effect. Look at that. And that's how you make some cool stuff using a simple balloon. If you enjoyed what I did, then please like, share, and subscribe. And most importantly, write something in the comment section below. I would love to know your ideas, your views, your feedback. And if you have any suggestions on how I can improve or what should I make or create for you guys for your home, school, family, friends, then do let me know. There's lots more cool stuff on my channel. So if you have the free time, then please watch. I'll see you next time. Until then, be good and do good. Peace.